Hello guys, my name is Webaffoh from webaffohgh.com and you are welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to learn how to create pages, how to create menus and how to create submenus. We are also going to learn how to add things to our WordPress website. If you are new to my channel, smash the subscribe button, click on the bell icon to turn on the notifications so that you don't miss any further video. Without much ado, let's get started. So in our previous video, we learned what is WordPress and how to install WordPress locally on your computer. Then we also went through the various menus in the WordPress dashboard. So if you missed that video and you didn't watch it, then you can still watch it. You can go to YouTube and then search for webaffohgh.com and then search for how to install WordPress locally on your computer. You can watch that video and then move along with us. So let's get started with today's video. So this is the interface of the localhost plugin. In our previous video, we learned how to download the localhost plugin so that you can be able to install WordPress. That's what we are still going to use today. We are still going to use the localhost plugin to install our WordPress. Alright, so if you didn't watch the previous video, so you don't know how to install the localhost plugin, you can still go to your browser, open the new tab, and then type wp-wordpress.com, and then you will be able to download the localhost plugin. So if you are able to download and install, we can continue from there. So in our last previous video, this is the website we created, webaffohgh. So we learned the various interface of localhost plugin. Today, one thing I want to emphasize on it that I didn't say it in the last previous video was that when you are using the localhost plugin, it will allow you to create many sites, as many as you can. This localhost plugin, it doesn't have any limits. You can create different websites with the same plugin as you have launched or as you have installed and opened it. You can create different websites at the same time. So in our last previous video, we created webaffohgh as our first website. Today we can create a different website. Okay, so if you didn't watch the previous video, you can still get advantage to watch this one, how to create a website from scratch using the localhost plugin. So today we are going to create a new website. We are not going to use the old website we created. We are going to create a new website. I want to use this opportunity to show you how you can create a different website. Okay, so when you come to the top corner of the plugin, you see this three dots line at the top corner. When you click on it, you see add new site. So you have created a site. Maybe you want to create a different site. Maybe this webaffohgh website is your personal website. Then you can also create a business website at the same time. So you can still be working on both of the two websites at the same time, right? So we are going to create a different website at the same time. So you see the add new site, you click on it, and then we land on this place, create a site. So there are two options here. Create a new site and create from blueprint. We are going to use create a new site. So create a new site, that's what we are coming to use. So you click on continue, and then this one says what is your site name. So choose a name that you suit your website. Alright, choose a name that you suit your website. The name that you choose, mind you that if you don't want to change the name later, then you can choose a better name for your website. Alright. But don't worry, you can change this name later on when you create your website. So it doesn't matter, you can change it later on. Alright. So as you are learning at this stage, what is your site name? So now today the name of the site we are going to create will be called Smart Learners. Smart Learners. Okay, this will be our site name, Smart Learners. So if you are okay with your site name, then click continue. Alright, you have another name, another new interface. This one says choose your environment. Okay, and then choose your environment. There are two options here. You have preferred and then the custom. The custom one is when you are maybe you have your own PHP version and then your SQL version that you know you want to use. That's the custom one. Maybe you want to customize your own version of the PHP or MySQL. But if you don't know much about it, just use the default one, preferred one. So we are going to use the preferred one. You know that the current version of the PHP is 7.4.1, and then Web Server, and then my SQL version also is 8.0.16. So this is the current version. When you saw a new web, this is the current version for my PHP and then my SQL. So we are going to use the preferred one. So we click on continue. And then we have landed at a different page. This one says set up a WordPress. Alright. So this one says WordPress username. WordPress username. This is a crucial point. Alright. In the previous tutorials, I showed you that when you reach at this point, this is a crucial point. And then the information you are going to enter in here is a confidential information. And if you forget this information you are going to enter it here, you can log in at the back end of your website when you are done creating the site. So whatever information you put it here, either being your username, your password, your WordPress email address, make sure you write it down so that you will not forget it. Because the moment you forget it, you can't log in to the back end of your website. Alright. So choose the username, okay? The username, the password, and the email address. And mind you that the email address you are going to use is a working email address. Make sure you choose a working email address. If the email address is not working or it's not proper, it can't work. Alright. So in this case, my username will be Afogable68, and then my email address will be afogable68@gmail.com. I believe you are also choosing a correct and working email address. So my password will be this. I hope you have also chosen a password that you can remember. So if you are done with this information you have entered, please write it down because you are going to use in the next step, right? So if you are okay with it, then you click add site. All right. So now we are creating a new site called Smart Learners. All right. So our website has been created. And here it is, Smart Learners. Smart Learners. This is our website we have created right now. So you see now we are having two websites. We have Webaffoh, which is working perfectly, and then Smart Learners. Smart Learners is also working. A dashboard. So now that the page has created, now we are going to learn how to create pages. Alright, so when you see the website now, you see that we don't have any page yet. The only one page we have here is the sample page, right? And this is our website title, Smart Learners. Alright, so we don't have anything on the website. So let's go and see if we can create some pages on our website. So we minimize. And then come to WP Admin. Click on WP Admin. It will take you to the back end of your website. And guys, this is your website back end information. But I told you that you should write down the username and the password. So here, before you can log in to the back end of your website, you have to enter your email and your password. Let me enter my email. And then my password. So you enter it. And boom, here it is. So this is the backend of our website, right? This is the backend of our website. So this is the WordPress dashboard. So in our previous tutorials, we learned about the various menus in the WordPress dashboard. So we went through about what is called posts, and then media, pages, comments, appearance, plugins, users, tools, settings. So guys, if you didn't watch the previous tutorial, that was WordPress Beginners Part 1. If you didn't watch that one, you can still go to YouTube and search for Webaffoh, then search for what is WordPress and how to install WordPress locally on your computer. So in your previous tutorial, you do explain all these various menus, right? So this is the back end of your website. So to create a new page, you have to go to pages. But before then, if you install a new WordPress, you see there are a lot of information on your dashboard. So you have to clean all those information so that your dashboard will be very clean and neat. So you can click on this list, you can click on this one, and then all this information here, you see post, comments, WordPress events and news. Let's clean everything here. So to do that, you see this screen option. So you click on the drop down, click on it, then you see all these boxes that have been ticked. These are the information down here. So if the first one is a site health status, you click on it to delete that one. Then you see at a glance, you see that one, to click on it. So this information go away. You see activities, click on it to go. You see quick draft, click on it, that one to Google. Then you see WordPress event and news, click on that one too. So now our dashboard is well clean. So when you are done, you click on the drop down to go back. So now we have cleaned our dashboard. So our dashboard is neatly clean, right? So when you install a new WordPress, you see more information must also be installed on the menus, especially the posts, the pages, plugins and things. You see, so when you go through one after the other, you see that you see some information in it. Meanwhile, we don't mind them. We have to click all this information so that our website and our dashboard will be very clean. We didn't explain it in the previous tutorials, but let's do it once again. So if you go to post, then you go to, if you go to post, you hover on it, you see all posts, click on all posts. You see, there's one information here, this hello world. So if you visit your website, you see, that is the information down here, hello world. So it's at your post page. So we don't like it here. We want our website to be neat. Every information that we put it here, we want that information comes from our own. So we will clean that one. So to do that, go to your dashboard, go to the post, all posts, and you see this hello world. So this box, title box, you click on it to check it. And then on the box action, click the drop down and you see move to trash. So click on move to trash and then apply it. So when you apply it, it will delete the default post. So click on apply. It's gone. So the default post has been deleted. So let's go to our page to see our website. So refresh. You see, it's gone. Hello world is gone. Right. Let's go to dashboard once again. And then let's come to pages. All pages. You see, there are some pages also in the sample pages. We have the privacy policy. It's there. It's not published. It's draft. So if you hover on it, you see draft. Meanwhile, it's not published. So it's hidden, but the link is still working. So if you click on it, it will take you to privacy policy page. So let's click on it and see. It has been saved. It's not published. That's why you don't see it at the front end of your website. So you see. Privacy policy for who we are, you see there are a lot of information here. Meanwhile, we don't like this information. We create our own privacy policy page. So, how can we do that? So, we delete that one and then the sample page. So, to do that, click on this title to select all. Then, on the box, actually drop down, click, and then select move to trash, and then click apply. So, all those various pages will be deleted. Right. All right, so let's go to appearance, and then we'll come to it later. Right, so now our dashboard has been well cleaned, so we are going to start everything from scratch. All right, and then when we come to appearance, you also see things. So if you click on it, you see there are some things here. All right, this is the default theme. So this is the 2022 theme that has been installed. That is what is on our website right now. Now we are coming to create a page. All right, we are coming to create a page. So to do that, but before then, there's one thing I want to emphasize on it here. The moment you install a WordPress and you don't have anything in mind, all right, a theme is the appearance of your website, is the arrangement of your website, is the layout, the overall layout of your website. That's a theme. Okay, so if you install a new WordPress and you don't have anything in mind to install, WordPress will give you a default one. Every year, WordPress gives a new theme out. So you see, we are in 2022. That's why you see the default theme is 2022. We have the 2021 year, and then we have the 2021. That was the last theme one was going to see. So every year, WordPress gives out a new theme. So when you install a new WordPress, automatically it will install a default theme for you. So now the 2022 theme has been installed. So if you go to your website, the front end of your website, the bed that you see it here on your hero page or your front page, the background color you see it here, how the title of your website, Smart Learner, has been written, and proudly powered by WordPress, everything you see it on your website now depends on this theme, this 2022 theme. You can change it, and everything you install will determine how your website will appear. Everything that you install will determine how your website will look like. So that's why I said a theme is the appearance of your website. Right, so now let's go and see. Let's go and change a different thing, then you see how our website will look like. So let's go to do that. Go to our dashboard and then go to appearance, then theme. So when you click on the theme, okay, so you see the 2022 theme has been installed and activated. So let's go and install another theme. To install another theme, the default ones here, you click any one of them. So let's see the 2020. So it has been already installed. So you activate it. So you click on activate. If you click on activate, you see the 2022 one has been pushed aside. And then the 2020 has taken over. So meaning the thing we are using right now is the 2020, not the 2022, because we have activated the 2020 thing. So as we have activated the new theme on our website, let's go to the back, the front end of our website to see how our website is looking like. So we go to the website and click on refresh because we have installed a new theme. You see now, look at how our website has been arranged. Our website has been arranged really differently. So you see the appearance of our website right now. You see archives, recent posts, recent comments, categories, and stuff. So all this information you see it here depend on the theme you are using right now. You see the 2022 theme was different, and the 2020 theme is also different. So a theme is the appearance of your website, is the layout of your website. Okay, so everything you see here is the is depending on the theme you are using right now. All right. So now, the thing we are using right now is the 2022. When we create pages afterwards, we also learn how to install our own theme, alright? So this is the default theme. So, to do that, Let's go to our dashboard once again. But each thing that you will install will determine how your website will look like. So when you install the 2020 themes, you see that now we have a lot of menus added to our website. So each theme will come with its own menus and its own styles and its own appearance, you see. So when you install the 2020, you see now we have customized widgets, menus, background, theme editor. But if you install 2020 theme, let's activate the 2020 theme once again and you see. Let's activate it. You see, so the moment you activate the 2020 theme, you see there are some new information right this thing on. This thing is called beta. Meaning the 2022 theme is a beta theme. This information is coming from WordPress. And if a theme is a beta, what does it mean? It means that they are still testing on some of the features. They are still working on some of the features. That's why 2022 theme, there's some mix of menus. So now, if you want to create a menu, you won't get the chance to create a menu because you are using 2022 themes. And the theme is a beta theme. So you don't get chance, you don't get the widgets, you don't get the menus, you don't get the customize if you install these 2022 themes. So maybe this theme has a limited features. So each theme will depend how your website will look like. So be careful about how you choose the theme, because the theme is the total appearance of your website. It will determine how your website will look like. So in this case, you will not like the 2022 themes because it's lacking some of the features. Because we're supposed to have some menus, so that we can create menus on our website. But now this 2022 theme is not having that features because it's a bigger theme. Alright, so let's go and install the 2020 theme. Well, let's go and install the 2021 theme. Okay, let's install the 2021 theme. It has not already installed, so click on activate. You see, the moment you activate the 2021 theme, you see a lot of features have been added, a lot of menu has been added. So meaning the 2021 theme is also powerful. It's also powerful than the 2022 because it's having more features, it's having customization, it's having the widget, it's having the menu, it's having the background, and it's having the theme file editor. So now you understand how a theme works on your website. So be careful about how you choose the theme. We are not going to use the 2022 theme, we are going to use the 2021 because it's having a lot of features. All the features that we will require on this tutorials, you will get it. Alright, so now that we are done with our theme, let's go and see how we can create pages on our website. So to create pages, you still go to your dashboard once again, and then come to pages. When you go over our theme, you see all pages, and then click on add new page. Click on add new page. But before you can create a page, when you visit any website, all right, you see there are different pages you create. For example, when you visit my website, webaffohgh.com. This is my website. You see there are different pages on the website. Okay, you see home, about, services, contacts, and then the blog. So each page come out with its own information. So any website you visit, you see different pages. Okay, so here in the case, on our website, now you want to create a page. So what page do you want to create? If anyone visits your website, the first page the person will see is the home page. So in this case, we are going to create a page called home page. Home page or home. So when you type in home, then you click on publish, the group once again on publish, right? And then you see a different page called about. Alright, so let's go and create a page called about. Go to your page, then add new, click on add new, and then what page we are we going to create next? We want to create about page. The home page gives a summary of your website, everything that you do on your business, everything that you do in your business, everything that you do it on your website, it will summarize everything on your home page. And then the about page also will tell you who you are, information about your website, then the history of your business or the history about your website. So the about this page will give people, the visitors, more information about your business and yourself. So let's go and create about this page. So when I click on publish, then click on publish, click on publish. Right? So the next page we are going to create is called the services page. Right? Services page. And this services page will tell people about what you do, the business, the kind of business that you do, the kind of services that you render to people. So this a visitor visit to your service page, the person will know a little about the business that you do, or the information or the business that you render, or the services that you render to people. So the services page will give a broad information about your business or about your website. So let's go and create. But if you check on the top, you will see some plus icon, see new. You can also create a new page from here. You see page, when you click on it, it will allow you to create a new page. So the next page we are going to create is called services. Services. Services page. So when you are done, you click on publish, click on publish. And then the next page we are going to create is called contact page. So we want people to visit us. We want people to get information from us. So how can the visitor do that? Or how can people, or how can customers do that? The customer can reach you, or the customer can visit you through your contact page. Contact page, so that people can contact us, or people can reach us through that page. Alright? So let's go to our dashboard, and then go to pages, add a new page, and then this page will be called contact page. So when you are done, you click on publish, you click on publish, right? So the last page you want to create is called the blog page, and then the blog page will allow people to read news about our website or to read information about our business. So the blog page also serves as the news page or information page. Okay, so if people want to read more about our business, or people want to read more about our website, the person go to the blog page, the person can get a lot of information to read right from your blog page. So let's go and create a page called a blog page. You can also name it as a news page, or you can also name it as an information page. It doesn't matter, it depends on how you name your page, right? But formally, the standard one people, what people feel talking about, people have been doing is the blog page. Okay, so let's follow the standard and do the same thing, right? So to create a blog page, go to pages, click on add new, and then we create this page called blog page so that people can read more information about our business or about our site. So you click on publish, click on doing once again publish. So now we have done creating our pages. We have created about 4 or 5 pages right now. So, what are we going to do now? So now that we have created the Google pages, let's go to our website to see. Let's visit our website to see. Let's refresh. You see, nothing is here. Oh, a lot of pages we have created. Why is it not showing here? The pages we have created is not showing here because we've not assigned a page to any menu. Right, we have not assigned any page that we have created. A lot of the things we have created is hidden in our website. We've not published it, we've not assigned it to any menu. So, the pages we have created, we've not given any command where to show it. So, it's also hidden in it. So, we have to give a command that we want these pages we have created to show it here or here. So, how can we do that? How can we make our page that we have created to show it at the back end of our website? So to do that, go to the dashboard once again. And then we go to appearance, then we go to menus. This is where I told you that if you are choosing a theme, you should be very careful about the theme that you are using. So in this case, right now we have created a page, and then the page is hidden in our website. Then we want to bring it at the back end of, at the front end of our website, so that people can see the pages we have created. Right now, that assuming you are using the 2022 things, meaning we can do this, so that the pages we have created will still be hidden in our website, people cannot see. So be careful about the thing that we'll be using. Okay, so now we are using the 2021 theme, which is powerful. It's giving us the requirement that we need, it's giving us the information that we want, right? So we come to appearance, we come to menus, then we click on menus, and then let's go and create a menu. So the menu will help us to bring out the pages we have created at the front end of our website so that people can see the various pages. So what menu are you going to give to your menu? So you see the menu name. So this one we are going to call it main menu. We are going to call it main menu. Why main menu? Because there are a lot of menus that you'll be creating on this website. Okay. We call a menu footer menu. We also call a navigation menu. We also have a menu called main menu or primary menu or top menu. So we have a different types of menus, right? This menu you see it here, the WordPress dashboard, the various menu you see it here called a sidebar menu, right? We have a lot of menus. So that's why the menu that you'll be creating, you have to give it a name. So in this menu, we call it main menu, right? And when you visit my website, you see the menus you see at the top of your website is called the main menu. This is the main menu. So this is the one you visit your website. The pages that the person you see at your main menu or at your top menu or at your header menu, right? When you scroll it down at the bottom of the website, at the bottom of yours, you see a different menu here. So the menu you see is here, home, about services, contact, and blog, is the same menu you see at the bottom here. We have home, about services, contact, and blog, right? Why do we do that? Because we don't want people to get lost on our website. So assuming, this menu you see it down here is called the footer menu. And what you see at the top here is called the primary menu or the main menu. That's why I'm saying that the menu we have created, we call it main menu. So that it will show it at the top of our website, right? Why do we create a different menu? Well, as I said, We don't want people to get lost when someone visits your website. Because if you create only top menu, then the person go to a different page and the person can't come back. You see, maybe the person is ready, maybe the person has gone to a different page altogether. Assuming the person has visited my privacy policy page. This is a page, it's also a page, and it's working, right? So assuming the person has visited my privacy policy page, the person cannot come back. Or maybe the person will be looking for other things to do, but they can't come back. So if you are having the menu at your footer, the person can easily go there to either your home about or your services page, right? That's why it's important to create a different menu, right? So this menu will be called main menu, right? And then there's some information also here. You say menu setting. You say auto add pins. So when you select this one, any page that you create, automatically it will add up to the top menu or the main menu. And then this one also says display location. So the menu we have created, where is it going to be located? So you see here, primary menu and then the secondary menu. Because as I told you that we are going to create a different menus, right? So where we want to display this menu will be primary menu. So you click on primary menu. So when you are done, you click on create. You see? So the moment you click create menu, you see that the pages we created is now live here. So now we are going to add this page to our menu. So to do that, you can select all the pages we have created, blog, contact, service, about, home, right? You can also, if you want it a quick way, you can also select all and then everything will be selected and then click on add menu. So the moment you click on add menu, you see now the pages we created, we can now have access to the pages right now. So the pages are added to our menu. So when you are done, then you click on save menu. So click on save menu. Click on save menu. So the moment you click on save menu, this page is repeated, we will add up to the top of our website, to the front end of our website. So now let's go and see if it is true that the menus have been added to our website. So let's go to our website and then click on refresh. Now you see the page we created is now live. The front end of our website. So now, this one, assuming we are done with this website we have created, we have published it live on the internet. These people go to our page, the person will see these various pages we have created right now. You see. But there's one thing missing here. When you visit any professional website, you see that the first page is the home page, and then the about page, then the services page, then the blog, and then the contact. But look at how the pages we created has been disarranged. Meaning, because this blog is the first page, meaning if anyone visits our website, the first page the person will see is the blog page, followed by the contacts, followed by the services about, before the last page will be home. This means our website pages is not well organized. This is not a professional work. So how can we do it in a professional way? To do it in a professional way, we have to arrange it nicely. So how can we arrange the pages we have created in order? To do that, we go to our dashboard once again. Go to our dashboard, click click on that button, and then you go to appearance, then you come to menus, click on menus, and then you see the various pages you created. Then you add it to your menu, you see that it's here. So you can arrange the pages you've created right at your menu page. Okay, so the blog page you see it at the top here, that's what will come first, right? So now you want to arrange it orderly. So to do that, you click on the home page, you want the home page to appear first, so you click on it. When you drag the mouse, so you see that the cursor will turn to something like plus icon. So the moment you turn on that, you click and then you hold and you drag it on top of the block. So the moment you drag it top, meaning the whole page will come first, followed by about. So let's click on about. Click hold and drag it under the home. New. You click and drag it. Let it be in line. And then the next page will be our sales page. You click and hold and drag it. Good. WordPress is so powerful, you see. You just say drag and drop, then you are home. Then we have the services, the contacts, and then the blog. We want the blog to be the last page, right? All right. So now that you have arranged it all done here, you click on the save menu once again. You click on the save menu. And then you go to your website. You can come here, visit site. You can also sit and click on the visit site and then let's refresh. So when you refresh, you see now our menus or our pages have been arranged nicely. So if the person visit our website right now, the person will see our home page first, followed by our address, followed by our services, followed by contacts, followed by blog, right? So we have also arranged our pages orderly. Now, the next thing we want to do is, now we have able to create pages. We have able to know the differences between various themes, the default themes. The next thing we want to do is how to create sub-menus, right? How to create sub-menus. Assuming now someone visits our services page, what service do you render? Maybe you render a different services. You have to showcase all those services that you render at your services page. So to do that, you have to go and create sub menus under your services page. So now the services that you render, you want to tell people that if someone visits your website, you want to tell the people that these are the services I do, these are the services I render, these are the things I do in my business, these are the things I do on my website. So let's go and create sub menus. So to do that, go to your dashboard, go to your dashboard, and then let's go and create sub menus. And then the sub menus we are going to create is also a page. So we are going to create a different page. Right, so to do that, I hope you remember that to create a new page, you go to pages, you come to add new, and click on add new. Right, so now what services do you provide in your business? Maybe you are a web designer, so on your website, you tell people that you render web design services. So here is the case. This page we call maybe web design. This one services that you render or you provide or you do. So if you are okay with it, you click on publish, you click on publish, a photographer, right? So maybe photographer. We are photographer. So we create a page for that services photographer. Or no, it's a photography. Right, it's photography. Is a service you render, photography service. Click on publish, click on publish. And then the next service that maybe you want to do is maybe, so you go to get add new, you click on add new, and these services will be called maybe video editing, right? Okay. So, how can you add these pages you have created to your various pages that you have? So, to do that, then let's visit our website once again. Let's refresh. We have refreshed, but it's not reflecting here. But I told you that when you create any new page, you have to assign the page to a menu. So now, the pages we have created so far, let's go and add it to our menu. So to do that, you go to your dashboard, you go to your dashboard once again, then you come to appearance, then you come to menu, click on menu, menu is already there. So you see that the pages we created is here, it has been added to our menus. So let's go and add it to our main menu. So click on add. So the moment you click on add, it will go and add it to our various pages. Yes, so it has been added here, editing, photography, web design. So when you are done, then you click on save changes. And here it is, you see, it has been added to our pages. So now our pages are home. About services, contact, blog, video editing, photography, and web design. So these three pages are the services that we render. But we don't want these pages to add to our main menu or to our main page. We want these pages to be a sub page under the services page. So how can you do that? To do that, go to your menus. So go to your dashboard once again. And then go to appearance, come to menu, and then let's add our those services page under the services page. How can we do that? How can we create a sub menu? To do that, just click on the page, you drag it under the services. So we have the web design. We want the web design to be our first sub menu. So you click on web design, you click the drag under the service page. So when you reach under the service page, then you also drag it, you also shift it small. So the moment you shift it and you release it, you see that it has automatically created a sub item. This is called a sub menu, right? So it has been created a sub menu or sub item. Okay. The same thing. So web design, photography service, so also click and drag under the web design. Also shift it small to align with the web design, then you release it. The main thing I want to create a subject or some item. Then the last thing, video editing, you click. You drag it under the services. So under the services, you also shift it. When you shift it, you release it. When you release it, you create a sub menu. So this is how we create a sub menu. You just click, you drag, then under the page that you want to create a sub menu or sub page, you shift it, then you release it to create a sub menu. So when you are done, then you click on save changes. Boom, it has come. You see this plus icon? The plus icon meaning that we have there are other items under this services page. So when you hover on the services page, you see this drop down, the web. So the services we do under services page, we also do web design, photography, and video editing. So guys, this is how we create a sub menu, right? This is how we create a sub menu. So the last thing we want to do is how to add an external thing to our website. You go to your dashboard, go to your dashboard once again, and then you go to appearance, then come to themes, then you click on themes. Click on themes. So these are the default themes, right? So now we don't like the default theme. We want to add our own theme. So how can we do that? So you see, add new theme. Then search install theme. So you can scroll into there. You can scroll into. So one thing I want us to install is called CD. CD. So let's search for CD. Let's search for CD. And this is the theme, right? CD. So you click on install. You click on install. So CD theme is installing. Good. So our theme has been installed. So let's activate it. Right. You see, we have activated our theme. So now let's go to our website and then refresh the page. So this theme is so powerful and so nice, right? So guys, it's all I have for you today. So in our next tutorials, we are going to learn how to add plugins to our website, right? And that one is also another powerful topic. So make sure you hit the subscribe when you click on the red icon to turn on the notification, so that if I upload the next video, you will miss it. Guys, thank you so much and see you next time. Bye bye.